Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at how to get rid of unwanted links in word processing documents. So here's the situation. You're using a word processor and you type a URL. And you can see what happened here is automatically that URL converted into a link. It became blue and underlined, and now if I move my cursor over it, you see I can click on it, and clicking on it will open the browser and open that page. But perhaps that's not what you wanted. For instance, if this is a document only for print, then of course they really can't click on it. It's going to be on a printed page. Or perhaps you just want to refer to the website, but you don't want to make it a clickable link. So the problem is that you want to get rid of this as a link, but keep the text there. Well, there's a way to do this that's very easy without changing any preferences or anything. And that's simply to use undo. See, undo will undo the last action. There are actually two actions that just took place. One was me typing those characters, and the other was those characters being converted into a link. So when I hit undo the first time, that conversion will be undone, but it won't undo the previous action, which is me typing. Watch what happens when I do Command-Z. There we go. It converted it back to normal plain text. Now I can continue typing and it won't try to convert it again. So that's a handy way to just have it stop for that one time you do it. And if sometimes you want it to be a link and sometimes you don't, then that's the way to handle it. But you also can go and change things to preferences. Text edit, for instance, under the new document preferences, I can turn off smart links. And if in my current document I want that to go away, I can go to edit substitutions and turn off smart links. And now that won't happen anymore as I'm working on the document. Now the same happens in pages. If you type a link there, it'll convert it. And I can also use undo, Command-Z, and it will stop it. But I can also go into preferences in pages and I can turn on or off automatically checked email and web addresses under auto correction. And that will stop it from doing it in the first place. Now a common thing that comes up is what if that was turned into a link. I'll Command Shift C to redo that. And now I want to get rid of it. Maybe it was a while ago and it's too late to undo and changing the preference isn't going to go back and change this. Well, you can select this and then go over to the inspector here and click on link in the inspector. And you can see there it's a hyperlink, enabled as a hyperlink with the URL it goes to. I can simply turn that off to convert this back to normal plain text. Now let's go back to text edit and see how we handle it there. It's too late to undo. I've typed some other things and I've saved and opened again, so I can't undo it. And changing a preference won't change this specific instance back. But if I control click or two finger tap on the trackpad, I get a menu here. And one of the things that I can do in that menu is remove link. And lastly, let's go to Microsoft Word. And we can see Microsoft Word does the same thing. And I can Command-Z undo to undo that one there. So I can still use that trick even with Microsoft Word. Now in Word I can turn this off by going into Word Preferences here and under Autocorrect I have the ability to go to Auto Format as you type and turn off Internet and Network Paths with Hyperlinks. So now when I finish with that, I can now type and it won't turn it into a link. And how do I undo a previous one? Well, I can control click on it, bring up a menu. And there are other ways that you can get to it as well. Get to this hyperlink menu where I edit hyperlink. And you can see it's all there, kind of like it is in Pages in the Inspector, except I have a big button here. It says remove link. And there you go. It's back to normal text. And you'll find that a lot of other word processing apps or any apps that handle text have a similar ability. You can use Command-Z to get rid of the change to hyperlink right after you do it. And you can turn on or off in the preferences. And there's usually a way to get rid of a hyperlink after it's already become a hyperlink and you want to change it back later on. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.